neighbor. That's right, love them, not kill them. Kill them's a bad thing. That's not loving your neighbor. That's killing your neighbor. And we don't want to be promoting that as we're saying love your neighbor.
Braxton Barker.
Oops, sorry.
Nice to meet you.
How you doing? Nice to meet you.
I believe that
you
got
one of these.
Were you? Yes, I would actually love one of these. I heard that someone got into a confrontation a few days ago with someone. Did that happen?
No, not that I know of. We record everything, and we didn't see any confrontations. No. I mean, people that hate the truth will be very, very verbal about it.
I understand.
But as far as confrontation, sure.
Can I ask you a few questions?
Sure.
I just wanted to ask you what your testimony was.
What my testimony is?
Just a brief testimony. Like, how did you... I'm guessing you're a Christian, yes?
Yes, I am.
How did you become Christian?
Just heard him calling me, and I was obedient.
Yes, sir.
Okay. I was a false convert back in 1993, and by 3 years later, I was back in the world. But in 2005, God got a hold of me and told me what exactly it is he commands of me, and I submitted to him. And I've been walking with him ever since. Was on staff at a church for a few years, and then when God opened my eyes to the plight of that, God's image bearers, I could no longer be silent. And that's not a good message that goes with the churches today either.
Yeah. What church do you attend?
We have a home fellowship.
Home fellowship. Okay.
Yeah.
What do you believe? Like in regards to this. What do you believe?
We're abolitionists.
Okay.
We believe in the total abolition of human abortion.
Okay. Awesome. Why do you believe that?
Because each and every one of these babies is created in the image of God. Each one of these babies was placed in the safest place, the place of the incarnation.
Yeah.
Where our Lord came. But we have turned that place into a place of death. Each one of these babies, God knew them before they were even formed in the womb. And life begins much according to conception, you know, at conception. That's according to God's word.
So how many people have you like stopped any abortions? Like people who were going to have abortions?
Yeah.
They've said, you know, I'm not going to do it because, how long have you been doing this?
I've been standing out pretty much on a daily basis for over 3.5 years.
3.5 years. But do you work? Do you have an office?
No, I'm a disabled vet.
Oh, disabled vet. Where do you serve?
Huh?
Where do you serve?
I served in different places. Oh, okay. I was injured in an incident of domestic terrorism.
I'm very sorry about that. Thank you for serving our country, sir. You know, I'm a Christian myself.
Mm-hmm.
But, you know, whenever as a Christian, whenever I see stuff like this, it kind of moves me in a way, but not in the way that you would think. Because whenever I see this, I look at this and I see a lot of gruesome images. And
this is the truth.
Yeah, I'm not saying.
What was the most gruesome image of all times?
I'm not saying it's not the truth.
Let me ask you a question as a Christian. What was the most gruesome image of all time?
The death of Jesus Christ. On
That's right. That's right. And it was displayed for all to see.
Yeah, definitely.
Okay? We aren't going to hide the truth. See, they would like to hide the truth. That's why they stand in front of signs. They want to keep the truth hidden.
I'm just saying, really, my big question is, I just don't see. Yes, this is the truth. Mm-hmm. Definitely. I fail to recognize how this is the love of Jesus Christ.
How this is the love of Jesus Christ?
Now, let me stop.
Okay.
The thing is, it seems like you're focusing a lot more on the people that are getting abortions rather than the babies.
No, we're not focusing at all on the people that are getting abortions. We're speaking to each and every person here.
In here, you literally have a verse that says, do not be deceived, neither the sexually immoral, nor the adulterers, nor the idolaters, the homosexuals. It seems that you're pointing out these different groups of people and saying you're just not going to heaven.
That's scripture.
Yeah, no, it definitely
is scripture. So I'm not pointing that out.
But at the same time,
God's word is pointing that out.
I am a sexually immoral person. Mm-hmm. I have committed theft when I was a child, but I've done wrong things, but I am saved by the grace of Jesus Christ. Definitely. I've done these things in the past.
If you've repented, that's true.
Yes, definitely, definitely. But
But you don't continue to walk in those sins.
No, definitely not.
Excellent. Very good.
The thing, it just really, whenever you just send these verses to people, it just kind of, like, I understand that that's the truth, but Jesus didn't really walk around, like, saying, you're going to hell, you're going to hell.
So who did?
Who did?
Yeah. Who did?
Who did? Who
did?
Did what?
Okay. When Jesus went into the temple, okay,
yeah.
In John 2, Matthew 20, 23, outside the temple, okay, he wasn't saying nice things to make people feel comfortable in their sin. He was telling them the truth.
Which, could you show me the verse? I mean, I have my phone. I could pull it.
You can go to John chapter 2. John chapter 2, when he went into the temple.
Hey, Sammy.
Okay. John chapter 2. He went into the temple. And what was going on in the temple? They were selling. They were taking. They were stealing.
Yeah.
Okay. And what did Jesus react to that?
Yeah. He was very angry.
He was very angry. Okay. Yeah. So do you think he'd be less angry if we're killing his children?
Well, yeah. At the same time, I mean, I'm sure you've heard the parable of the adulteress, correct?
Of what?
The adulteress.
The adulteress, right.
Yes, where he brings out, and instead of casting the first stone, he says that, you know, your sins are forgiven.
Right. Go to the last verse of that parable.
Yes.
What does he say?
He says to go and sin no more.
He doesn't say go on and continue in your sin, hold up signs saying love no debate, and enjoy your sin.
Yeah, but at the same time, are they really sinning? Is this woman sitting right here?
No, right now, that's a beautiful.
That's a beautiful sign.
But actually, no debate.
Yeah.
The debate is what she considers love.
Yeah, except
it's a false love.
Well, that's really not a false love.
That actually is a false love.
God says that.
So if I wanted to love an animal, if I wanted to love a dog.
Well, no. You see, the thing is, actually, when you go into the Bible, there are four words for love. There's four Greek words for love. So you have a love for that is sexual. You have a love that is brotherly. You have a love that is for romantic. And then you have a final love that I really can't think of right now. So whenever Jesus uses the word, he actually uses like a brotherly and sacrificial love. They don't.
And what does the Bible say?
Yeah,
does somebody who hates you tell you the truth?
Well, yes.
No.
Actually, it does say that. It says that
the one who loves you will come to you and tell you the truth.
Yeah.
In the hopes that you will repent. It is the one who hates you who will deceive you into believing something else.
I'm focusing on the love aspect.
Right. I'm focusing on the love aspect too.
So what I'm saying is they don't necessarily mean a sexual love. They're not saying,
I'm not talking about a sexual love.
Yeah, I'm talking about a brotherly love.
Okay. That's fine.
Yeah. And I think you're talking about a brotherly love too. Okay, awesome.
That's right. And what is the most loving thing you could do is to tell the truth.
I mean, the most lovingly thing you can do is to show sacrifice to your brother. I mean, Jesus says that the most loving thing that you can do.
Yeah, but if that sacrifice is in deceit, then it is not love.
I mean, Jesus says the most loving thing you can do is put your life down.
Lay your life down for another.
Yes, exactly.
Okay.
So, really?
So let me ask you, since you're holding the sign, so she won't answer because she doesn't want to answer.
I mean,
because she believes in this kind of love.
No, you're putting words in her mouth.
Well, she won't answer.
She hasn't said anything. She doesn't have to say anything.
Oh, she doesn't have to say anything?
She's saying that there is love, no debate, that God loves everyone. It could be right.
That's not true.
Oh, so God doesn't love everyone?
No. What does God's word say?
Oh, God says
okay. let's look at the words.
Yeah, let's go ahead.
Okay. For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten son.
Definitely.
That whoever believes in him shall not perish, but have eternal life. But let's not stop there. Let's continue on. For Jesus did not come to condemn the world, but to save the world. But let's not stop there.
Yeah.
What do the next few verses say?
Yeah.
Okay.
Actually, let's pull it
John 3:18 through John 3:17, 3:18 through 20. Okay. You see, you can't twist God's word and give it your own meaning and say, hey, let's all love each other.
You see,
okay?
The thing is,
that's not biblical.
Yeah, no, it's not biblical. But the thing is,
that's what you're promoting.
No, I'm not promoting that at all. I kind of am promoting it, but
I know you are. That's why I'm, I'm not a guy, I'm like an ex-Marine, right?
Yeah, yeah.
Okay, I'm not going to sit here and dance with you.
Yeah.
I'm going to go right to your heart.
No, definitely. I think that's
because that's what's supposed to happen.
At the same time,
as somebody who's supposedly a brother.
But I think that you're inherently confused on what the verse says in John 3:16. No. You see, for God so loved the world that he gave his only son, comma. Do you know what a comma is?
Yes, I know what a comma is.
A comma breaks up two clauses. So it's basically you can convey two things in the same sentence. So it says, for God so loved the world that he gave his only son. So God has already established that he loves the world. God loves the world.
He loves the world because he created the world.
Yeah, the world and everything in it. Yeah,
that's right.
Yeah, we were brought up in man's image. She was brought up in God's image. She was. The people over here that are protesting.
They were created in God's image.
Yes.
They weren't brought up in God's image.
Well, created, whatever you may have it. But God loves those people.
Well, words are important, like you want to say with commas. Words are important.
Yeah, words are important. Do you think that God loves those people over there?
Does he love them?
Yeah, does he love them?
Yes.
God love those people.
Yes. But what else does God's word say?
Okay, no. You see, here's the thing.
You see, you can't take one verse and build your theology on one verse. All right? Yes, God loves them.
Yeah,
okay?
God does.
But what does God's word also say about sin?
I mean, God says that sin is a separation of us.
Actually, he says he hates it.
Yeah.
And he hates those who commit it.
Yeah.
They are at enmity with it.
Have
you know what enmity means?
Have you sinned before?
Oh, yeah, of course.
Yeah, so have I.
Right,
so.
But there's a big difference, okay?
Oh, yeah.
If you are covered in the righteousness of his son, or you're covered in the righteousness of yourself.
Okay?
God hates the proud. And God's word says that you give grace, you give love to those who are humble and contrite and repentant. But to the proud and the boastful, you give them the law.
Actually, God says you give love to everybody. I mean, let me go ahead. No, that's not enough. So, really, what I'm trying to get to here is I just really don't think that this is the proper way to do things.
Mm-hmm.
That's my opinion.
You're right, it's your opinion, okay? But see, if your opinion doesn't line up with Scripture, there's a problem.
Now you're
seeking to line yourself up with your will. What does Paul say in Ephesians 5:11? Go ahead. And by the way, those verses around 3:18 through 20 says that they saw the light.
Yeah.
They heard the light.
Yeah.
But they loved themselves more. They loved their darkness more. They loved their sin more.
Well, I mean,
that's John 3:18 through 3:20.
Okay.
And they are condemned already. For each of us are condemned since birth.
You know that they're condemned. You know that they're going to hell?
Every one of these people, and me, was condemned from the beginning.
Yeah, but do you think that they're going to hell?
If they don't have Christ, they're going to hell. That's the truth.
No. You see, here's the thing. I understand that. I actually believe that for a really long time. That if you, like I could basically say, okay, you don't have Christ, you're going to hell. Now, you see, I actually learned. I almost converted to atheism about 3 years ago. Mm-hmm. I had a very turning point in my faith. I am not an atheist, I'm still a Christian, but I changed a lot about what I believe. And you know, one of the things
So you made yourself a God?
I mean, I think I was of God before and after.
How's it going, brother?
But really, one of the big things with me is I don't know if those people are going to hell or not.
Well, then you're denying what Jesus said.
No.
Jesus said that if you are not covered by the sacrifice of his son, you are condemned.
No, the thing is, God also says...
And you have been since the fall.
No. God also says that... Let me pull it up here. In 1 Corinthians 2:11, it says here, for who knows a person's thoughts except the spirit of that person, which is him. And no one comprehends the thoughts of God except the Spirit of God.
Uh-huh.
Okay. Those people.
All these people. You don't have to just single out those people.
You do not know if those people are going to hell. Only God knows that.
But what else does God's word say? See, you have to compare Scripture to Scripture. See, this is what happens when you take a verse and you give it whatever meaning you want.
I'm not giving
it. It is by their fruit that they shall be known. Now you tell me, is this good fruit or is this bad fruit?
Listen.
It's a very simple question. Is this good fruit or is this bad fruit?
I don't agree with what they're really doing.
This is the truth. You don't want to know the truth.
Yeah.
You want to obviously somehow you have built a God that thinks, hey, this is wonderful. I love these people.
I love those people. I don't necessarily think that abortion is okay, but I mean, I love those people up there. I love her. I love all of these people. I love you.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, I just don't understand why we gotta sit out here. And yes, you are showing the truth, but I don't think that's a necessarily great way to show the truth. I mean,
so how would you do it?
I feel
how
like,
would you, how do you do it? Let me know how you do it.
Okay, well, I mean, the first things first, my goal every day is to bring people to Christ, okay, not to call out their sin.
Okay.
My, I mean, like, calling out sin is a great thing, but Jesus didn't go around and say, hey, fix your life before you come to me.
Right.
Jesus didn't go around saying, hey, you need to get this straight before you come to me.
Right. You can go right back to the parable of the woman caught in adultery.
Yeah.
But he finished it off with, go and sin no more.
Yeah.
Not continue on because I love you.
I definitely understand that, but at the same time,
oh man,
are they gonna stop?
Oh,
I mean, like, how are you this like doing what Jesus said?
So let's go to Ephesians 5:11 again.
Okay.
Yeah.
What the Apostle Paul said. And he's the greatest example of who can be saved. He is a man that used to hunt down Christians.
Yeah, oh no, I know Paul very well. Romans is my favorite book of the Bible. Take no part in the unfruitful works of darkness, but instead expose them.
So what does exposing look like? Staying home and hiding your light under a bushel? What is 24? Proverbs 24, verse 11 and 12.
I know Proverbs 24.
Okay.
Yeah,
defend those being led to this way. What is James 1:27? Practice pure and undefiled religion.
You know, Ephesians 5:11 is actually talking about the church. You do realize that.
If you are a professing believer, are you the church?
Oh, yes, I'm the church.
Okay, so then where is the controversy there?
Listen, these people are not the church, though.
Well, you just said that God loves them.
Well, yeah, God loves the church and not the church. He loves everybody.
See, this is what happens when you pick and choose.
No,
you're kind of, it actually it is,
no,
okay?
Really,
we are to expose, all right? You know how many of these people actually believe that they're Christians?
We're supposed to expose in private, because in Matthew 24...
Did you add to God's word?
No. In Matthew 24, let me show you.
Okay.
Matthew 24, he talks about... Hey, Allie.
Hey, dude.
How are you doing?
I'm good, how are you?
Let me see. I think it's Matthew, is it Matthew 4 or Matthew 24?
Let me ask you, was he a good man?
Isaiah? You know, I'm going to be honest. I don't know a whole lot about Isaiah. I haven't read much of him.
Isaiah.
He's the prophet, correct?
Yeah.
Thank you. He's a prophet, correct?
Yeah,
he's a prophet. He made many prophecies that eventually came true about Jesus Christ.
True.
Yes.
Is he a good man?
I would say so, yeah.
Okay. Jeremiah, is he a good man? Okay. How about Amos?
A lot of Old Testament names that I have not studied in a long time.
That's another problem. See, you can't take the Bible in pieces. You have to take it from the beginning of
the end.
Because
Jesus is in
Genesis 1 all the way through to Revelation.
No, I believe that.
Okay, so you have to read all of it.
Yeah.
Okay, what did Isaiah and Jeremiah and Amos and Malachi and Hosea, what did they do? When they saw people in sin, did they sit back? Okay.
I mean,
what did Jesus do when he saw people in sin?
Well, I mean, they brought a prostitute out below his feet and said, go and sin no more. So, I mean, and at the same time, whenever you're talking about...
Okay, that wasn't a prostitute. It was a woman caught in adultery.
Adultery, excuse me.
Okay.
I'm sorry. And whenever he went into the temple, that was a lot because there were people literally gambling and cheating in the temple.
That was in that was in John 2, but that was very good.
Yeah.
Okay. But that's not all he did, okay? He rebuked false teaching wherever it was found.
I mean, most of the rebuking done was against people that were false teaching, like the Pharisees, who were very prideful.
Oh, like the Pharisees, because they were bad people.
I mean, I'm not saying anyone is good or bad, necessarily. I mean, we're all sinners.
Uh-huh.
I'm a big believer in that. I mean, even Paul says that.
Right, but there's a big difference between someone who's living in sin, seeking out their sin, walking in their sin, reveling in their sin, enjoying their sin. Okay. Or somebody who goes and sins no more, who turns from their sin. What does repentance mean?
Yeah, repentance means go and sin no more.
Well, no, repentance means you turn 180 degrees. Yeah. You cry out to God because you know just how poor in spirit you are. That's from the Beatitudes, okay? Because those people are blessed. Those who know there's nothing good in them. Those who know what God's word says about their hearts, that their hearts are evil, that they're wicked, that they're deceptive above all things.
You know,
I encourage you, okay? I encourage you to read God's word in context, who he's writing it to, and what he's saying. Because I'm telling you, when you pull verses like that and you give them your own meaning, you know, that's not a good thing. That is what Joel Osteen does, okay?
Osteen
that is what T.D. Jakes does.
I agree with you on that. Joel Osteen does verses for his own benefit. I agree with you. You know,
that's what, unfortunately, a lot of these shepherds do today.
I just really fail to see what this accomplishes.
What this accomplishes is that you are exposing the truth.
I see that. Okay. In Ephesians, whatever it talked about, exposing the truth. Paul was literally referring to the church of Ephesians. Now, that can expand to all churches. That can expand. I think that's universal for all churches. There's a church that
expose the truth wherever it may be found. Okay?
Yeah.
Expose the truth wherever it may be found. All right? And that's what you do. When Jesus sent them out, two by two, okay? You notice, two by two, biblical.
Yeah.
Okay? What did he tell them when he came to a city and he was not welcome? He told them to kick the dust off of their feet because it would be better for Sodom and Gomorrah in those days than for that town. Okay? What we are doing here is we are... I don't remember. You can look it up. It's when he sent them out two by two. Okay? And he did it a couple times. All right? But what you need to do is you need to read God's word in context.
Yeah, I do.
Okay?
I do.
Yeah, but unfortunately today, here, you've quoted out of context.
I really...
And you've given it your own meaning.
What verse have I quoted out of context?
Well, you went immediately to the one that we have in the book, and you said that that's not what he was trying to say.
That's not what I was saying. What I'm saying is, if you walk around and tell all these people, hey, you're not going to inherit the kingdom of God right here, I don't think that's necessarily right. Because... you're basically, like, I mean...
So you're denying God's word.
No, I'm not denying God's word. I'm saying that if you're going around, like, if you're going around and just saying, look at this verse, you want to help, yada, yada, yada. Does that bring people to Christ, or does that push them away?
First off, I'm not telling anybody they're going to hell. I'm telling them what God's word says.
Yeah.
Every time, if you've watched our videos, and I've given a gospel presentation...
Here's the thing. You can go around and be like, basically, oh, I'm not saying this, God's saying this. Look, this is what God says right here.
Mm-hmm.
But really, like, think about that. Are you, what God's word says.
No, I know. And if you can read through this pamphlet and get to this, notice it's like the next to last page, okay? Get to this and still say, I want to kill children, then guess what? That is very appropriate for you.
The thing is, if you go around and just quote this verse and say, hey...
Well, first off, I'm not going around quoting that verse, all right? Like I said, if you take something out of context and you put yourself and give it your own meaning. Like, if you search through the Bible and you look at that verse and say, oh, look what God's saying. That's bad. You're denying God's word. You're taking it out of context. And the same thing here. If you take this and you flip to this and you look through and you say, oh, wait. Why? Jesus Christ entered the womb. That's good. But this bad.
No, I don't think this is bad. I fully understand that this is about to be.
Mm-hmm.
And I fully believe this. Mm-hmm. At the same time, I just don't think that we know who's going to hell and who's not. I don't think, even if God says, I mean, at the end of the day, God's the chooser.
That's true.
God is the one that says, you did not show love for me. You did not know me.
Well, actually, it's not that, okay?
I mean,
Like Jesus said, you're either for him or you're against him. There isn't a middle ground.
Oh, yeah.
Okay? And you know or you don't know. Okay? Now, he gives us plenty of areas in his word how we are supposed to look in people and we are supposed to be able to tell. Okay? In fact, many people in Matthew 7 will say, hey, judge not lest ye be judged. And then they stop right there. Okay? They don't look further down, yeah, where God's word tells us how to judge. We are to judge righteously according to his word.
Yeah, it actually talks about judging Christians, other Christians.
That's true. In that instance, yeah, you're right. Yeah. Okay, but what I'm trying to make a point here is he tells us in his word how to judge. Okay, how to judge rightly. Okay, and it is according to his word. It is not according to how I feel.
Yeah.
Okay, not according to how I feel.
Yeah.
If it was according to how I feel, first off, I'm the first one who would go to hell.
Yeah.
Okay, because I am poor of spirit. There is nothing good in me but Christ. All right, so I can't judge you, yeah, and I can't judge them, and I can't judge them according to my feelings. All right, there are some people here who are so. Yeah, I don't remember doing that, but I'm sure if you could show me that, then you can stop slandering and lying.
All right. Did you call any of these people prostitutes yesterday? Or the day before?
No. That's why we record everything.
Yeah.
Okay? That's why we record everything.
Well, all right?
Because we're accountable.
Yeah.
We're accountable to you. We're accountable to them.
Yeah.
We're accountable to them. If I said something that was not biblical, I have to apologize.
You called me a prostitute.
I didn't call you a prostitute.
Yes, you
you're
did.
A liar.
No, absolutely.
Now you're calling her a liar.
Well, if she's gonna lie, that's what do you call a person
well,
that lies?
You can say that someone is lying, but I mean, if you're calling her a liar, that technically is judging.
What's that?
Yeah, technically is judging if you're calling someone a liar.
But if they're lying, well, what do you call? Well, so you can't even distinguish the truth from lies now?
No, you can say like you are lying. You can state a fact, but to say you are a liar, you are a prostitute, you are an adulterer, you are a drunkard, like I would say that's judging.
So. If somebody kills somebody, what do you call someone who kills somebody?
I mean, you could call them a murderer, but I wouldn't call them a murderer under the law of God. I mean, I would call them a murderer under the law.
See, again, you're denying what God's word says.
Yeah, okay.
All right? A person that kills is a murderer.
Yeah.
All right? A person that kills is a murderer. First off, you got to get in your head first of what actually is in here. Okay? If you steal... You could call them a thief, but I wouldn't call them a thief. Well, you're denying the truth.
Okay.
And unfortunately, if you deny the truth in one spot, you have to deny it in all the spots. You can't pick and choose which truth you're going to follow.
Okay, so you shall not make any cuttings in your flesh for the dead, nor print any marks on you. I see you have a tattoo on your arm. You're just going to pick and choose out of the Bible what you want to follow?
I actually have 9 tattoos, ma'am.
Okay, then according to the Bible... By your own logic, then that's a sin.
Well, you see, actually, that's a Levitical law, which only applied to the Jews
right.
and Israel.
See, this is what happens when people take the word and they use it for their own.
I'm not saying that, okay. I mean, like, I'm a rational person. Like, if someone just quotes a Bible scripture and it's just like, hey...
You're saying you're a rational person, and so that means she's not?
No,
are you judging her?
I didn't say that she wasn't irrational.
Well, you just said that she quoted this, and she's not right. I'm a rational person.
I'm saying that she didn't. I'm saying that she has a misunderstanding of the context of the verse. I'm not saying that she's an irrational.
Right, and that's true. That's true. Okay, I wouldn't call her irrational.
I did say that I am a rational person, which could imply that she's not. So I understand. I apologize. I should have said that.
Okay.
You know, man, I have to get to school, but
okay.
You know, I really just don't see how this... Yeah, I'd love to take many panels to get before I could learn more about it. But I just really think that the things that you're accomplishing here are not as great as you could be if you were really more so professing the love of Jesus Christ.
We are professing the love of Jesus Christ. And believe me, it was the love of Jesus Christ where I pointed out each and every time.
I don't see any
love of Jesus Christ when you called me a prostitute on Tuesday.
Okay, ma'am. Like I said,
first
off, I didn't call you a prostitute. Okay. So whatever.
I don't see any signs that are talking about Christ's love for everybody.
Because Christ doesn't love everybody. You still are stuck on that.
Yeah, no.
You're still stuck on that. Okay? Does God love people that he sends to hell?
I love you so much. Uh-huh. And I love all these people, uh-huh. but I really can't sit here any longer if you're going to tell me that God doesn't love everybody. Because that's something I believe with all my heart. And if you don't believe that,
if you deny Christ, what did Jesus say? If you're ashamed of me, I will be ashamed of you.
You're, see you, man.